Seventh, welcome to class. Today we're going to be looking at this account on TikTok called The Viet Vegan. This person comes from a Vietnamese background, presently lives in Hamilton, Ontario, but she does not use her culture as an excuse for not being vegan. She is vegan, and she's vegan for ethical reasons. So let's look at a few of her TikToks.
Lately, I've been getting a lot of people asking me why I'm vegan because I don't really fit in the perception of like a healthy smoothie drinking vegan. I don't love telling people why I'm vegan because people always feel like they're being judged or they get super defensive, but frankly, the animal industry is pretty awful and I realize that you can eat delicious food while doing as much as you can to abstain from contributing to that industry. And this is coming from someone who ate a lot of meat growing up. My dad's favorite food was sushi and hot pot with extra seafood and meat, so we ate a lot of meat. I would help my mom with chopping veggies, scaling and gutting fish, prepping meat for dinner. All this to say, I never thought I would go vegan. My motivations for going vegan are ethical and environmental. Mass deforestation for animal feed production, battery cage practices, culling of male chicks, how the dairy industry is what enables the veal industry to exist. It's a lot. Once I realized that so many of the foods that I love, like creamy, meaty stroganoff, could be veganized, I decided that I could eat delicious food without someone dying for my dinner. I started seeing animals as individuals with personalities and desires to live. They became some ones instead of some things to me. Cows are essentially giant grass puppies. I've met turkeys who love to cuddle, pigs love belly rubs, and ducks and chickens often have mates or best friends and follow each other around. Now, that doesn't negate the fact that I loved eating meat. Animal products taste good, and I like tasty food, which is why I generally eat the same way I ate before I went vegan, just without the animal products. Lately, I've been getting a lot of people asking me why I'm vegan because I don't really fit in the...
All right, so that's one video. Let's look at another one. This one had 2.5 million views.
Some people ask me if I feel like I miss out on Vietnamese culture at all as a vegan. It can definitely feel that way sometimes. A lot of foods around the holidays can be vegan because of Buddhist traditions, and a lot of Vietnamese foods are inherently vegan, like this bun hoi, which are these flat sheets of noodles cut in two squares and then seasoned with mỡ hành, which can be made with either scallions or flat chives, which is what I'm using today. Party foods like đại yao are typically made with pork, and sometimes I'll get lucky and my family will have a batch of vegan ones for me, but that didn't happen very often until my mom and my brother went vegetarian a few years ago. Vietnamese culture is all about eating together, bonding over food together, and when I first went vegan, I often had to eat at a separate table while my family ate hot pot or made quai gung together. My family took a long time to accept that I was vegan, even though they would excitedly explain to family friends that I didn't even eat eggs or dairy. I think they thought that I was allergic, but when I explained that I chose not to eat them, they always seem a little confused. I've tried explaining, but it just feels like they think that I'm being difficult. Sometimes it can feel really lonely to be vegan, and I found it so lovely connecting with people online and getting excited over foods to veganize. I never thought I would be able to eat again, which is why some people ask me if I feel like I miss out on Vietnamese culture at all as a vegan. It can definitely feel that way.
All right, so that was two videos. She's also got one here about how she makes seitan. This one is about vegan grilled cheese. Here's a creamy garlic dip. Here's one about vegan chili. Let's click on that.
What's my secret to a fantastic chili? Chili is all about a balance of veggies, spice, meatiness, and beans. A good selection of veggies is important here. I'm using a mirepoix of onions, carrots, celery. I use Impossible Meat here because that's Eddie's favorite, but I've used TVP, Eve's, Beyond before, and they've all been great in their own way. You could just do just beans, but I find the little beefy bits really makes this indistinguishable from non-vegan chili. Then I add a few bell peppers because I had extra in my fridge. Add extra savory flavor with a vegan beef or vegan chicken broth paste. I usually use barley, but I was making this for someone allergic to gluten, so I use quinoa instead. You want a small grain that will fill the gaps between the beef and the vegetables that will soak up the extra liquid. Use whichever you prefer. Add diced tomatoes, beans, a bit of extra water to clean out the cans. I go heavy-handed with the chili powder, and the warming spice that adds an extra oomph is cinnamon. Cover and cook, stirring every 5 to 10 minutes on a steady simmer until you get this. I surprised so many people with my chili that they asked me, what's my secret to a fantastic chili? Chili is all about a balance of veggies, spice, meatiness, and beans.
All right. So, do you like this account? I do. I find it's really cool. She's got so many different recipes here. And she also talks about her childhood a little bit. I found this one kind of cute.
My take on a Vietnamese bento with chai hoc chai, chá trứng chai, đậu chua, cơm tấm, tomato, and cucumber for freshness. I didn't really grow up eating this much, only when we went to restaurants on our monthly grocery trips, which we did in Toronto because I lived in a small town a couple hours away, which had no Asian grocery stores. The town that I grew up in only had two other Vietnamese families, and we all went to different schools. I remember bringing Pocky to school, and my school crush just made fun of me and told everyone that I was eating Play-Doh on sticks. I was so afraid of having Vietnamese food at school, and I remember remember trying so hard to assimilate and just be not Vietnamese as much as possible. Nowadays, I look back and I'm sad about how much I tried to escape my Vietnamese roots. And now with a baby on the way, all I want to do is learn more about my culture and reconnect so that my kid will be proud of where they're from. I hope they would love to bring a Vietnamese lunch to school like this, which is my take on a Vietnamese bento with jai hoc jai, jia chung jai.
Isn't that wonderful? She wants to connect with her roots, her Vietnamese roots, and she's not embarrassed about it, but she's just managed to veganize all of her meals. And here she talks about what she eats in a day as a 7-month pregnant woman, vegan, and she does all kinds of other things here. So I encourage you to have a look at her channel. Be creative, be an amazing vegan, and remember that your culture is no excuse for animal abuse, as you can see by her perfect example here. So thanks a lot for coming to class today. If you know of any other vegan accounts that you think I should cover, let me know. Coming up on screen are going to be a bunch of other videos. Click on them. Be curious. Follow that vegan teacher's channel. Subscribe. Hit the notification bell. And help me get the animals out of hell. Thanks so much for being here. See you all in the next video. Bye for now. Do, 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 do.